Arson attacks cost Metrorail R5 $20 million in damages. Cape Town, Metrorail suffered damages to the tune of R5 $20.8 million due to arson attacks, which saw 174 trains go up in smoke in the past 4 years. The attacks crippled the local rail service, which now has only 44 out of 88 train sets operating. Local advocacy groups have petitioned President Cyril Ramaphosa to declare Cape Town's trains, which are run by the Passenger Rail Association of SA, PRISA, a national disaster. In his State of the Nation address on Thursday night, Ramaphosa said he was taking steps to get state-owned enterprises, SOs, such as PRISA back on track. We want our SOs to be fully self-sufficient and be able to fulfill their development and economic role. We have established the Presidential SO Council, which will provide political oversight and strategic management in order to reform, reposition, and revitalize SOs, Ramaphosa said. The former acting chief executive at PRISA, Duthuzeli Swartz, was dismissed last November and later charged with fraud, money laundering and theft of railway lines and sleepers to the tune of R1.5 million. To restore proper corporate governance, new boards with credible, appropriately experienced, and ethical directors have been appointed at Eskom, Enel, Transnet, Safcal, PRISA and SA Express, Ramaphosa said. Last year, 56 coaches were destroyed in attacks on the Western Cape's commuter rail service. There have been no new arson attacks since October, when two trains were set on fire in Cape Town Station, while just a few kilometers away, Transport Minister Blade Nzimande and PRISA were busy briefing Parliament about how they plan to stop train attacks. Metrorail spokeswoman Rihanna Scott said a joint effort between Metrorail Protection Services, SAP's Rapid Rail Response Unit and private security contractors has resulted in hundreds of arrests since March. Last year, Metrorail Western Cape acquired forensic ability, deployed additional armed security in priority areas and implemented surveillance technology. Arrests started to increase immediately and the first conviction followed soon. Anonymous tip-offs contribute to a significant number of arrests, Scott said. While trying to repair and replace lost coaches, Metrorail engineers are also fighting to modernize the service against a scourge of metal theft, vandalism, and decrepit old infrastructure. The full modernization of the Western Cape's rail service is anticipated to cost R9 billion. A significant chunk of that expenditure will be on new trains, with R3 billion earmarked to replace lost sets. Depot modernization will cost R2.6 billion, station upgrades R1.6 billion, and resignaling R1.2 billion. Projects underway total R292 million. Scott said Metrorail had already completed its new nerve center, from which all the signaling of trains would be monitored, and several areas already had new signaling installed and were operational. However, vandalism is delaying improvements where they are most desperately needed. The central area as the busiest line was designated to be modernized first. However, due to the devastating impact of vandalism and theft in the Bontahuel-Netreg-Nyanga triangle, only 2 out of 4 lines remain operable, she said. The next stations to be upgraded are Nolungjil, Bontahuel, Mandalay, Lentasyer and Stock Road. The new Philippi station is nearly complete. Metrorail has already launched the rail enforcement unit to boost security and crowd management on trains, partly funded by the city council. This put 100 extra law enforcement officers along the system.